I've talked in previous source focus episodes about the ability to use a video source or VLC video source in your streams. But how does that perform? What kind of video files should you be using? Can you optimize this to make your stream setup more lightweight? Let's discuss this here. The Elgato Cam Link takes your mirrorless, DSLR, GoPro, or camcorder and turns it into a higher quality face cam than any webcam could ever provide, without the hassle and headache of normal USB webcam drivers or their terrible settings configuration. Get an uncompressed, low latency 1080p 60 signal from your camera straight to your stream with this little device right here. Buy one via the link in the video description. I'm MeeplesVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on the software in the course playlist linked in the description below. Check that if you have any questions, I've probably answered them, and check the introduction video to learn how this whole course actually works if you get confused. While, depending on your system specs and such, most video files will work just fine as media sources within OBS Studio, you can make your life easier by converting your sources to a lighter video format to make OBS do less work. You only really need to do this for regularly used source files, for animation overlays, stinger transitions, and so on. Just a one-off gameplay clip probably doesn't need to be converted before being added to your stream in OBS to just show like once or twice. For ease of use within OBS Studio, I actually recommend using the WebM video format. This is an open source media file format designed for the web and will let you convert your graphics, intros, or video clips to small compressed video files that are easy to use and keep together within a stream resources folder and playback smoothly within OBS Studio without worrying about performance. Unfortunately, most proprietary production tools don't get along with web formats like this. There is a WebM plugin for Adobe Premiere Pro for Mac and Windows that you can install and use, though last time I tried it, rendering performance wasn't great. It is an option if you wish to stick with Premiere, however. Just run the MSI installer with your Adobe apps closed, potentially reboot, and then choose WebM from your output settings and set up a preset. Alpha Channel is even supported, so you can make your overlay graphics, which is very important if you're actually making your graphics from scratch. You want to keep this all together. This works from versions CS6 and up. If you're using another video program, you'll probably have to render to an intermediate video format, such as just an uncompressed AVI or MOV or something, and then convert it from there. Alternatively, you could break out the command line for FFmpeg and convert your video file manually that way. But for the lazy of us, myself included, there's WebM Bro, an open source GUI frontend for FFmpeg available for free on GitHub specifically for the purpose of converting clips to WebM. Go to the GitHub project page, click on the releases section, and download the webmconverter.zip file. Extract the files with your favorite archive manager such as 7-zip and close it. Find the files you just extracted and run the webmconverter.exe. Here, you can choose a source file to convert and where you want the converted file to go. You can leave everything else alone, or you can customize things such as the title, resolution, bitrate, manually set a file size limit, and so on. Once you're ready, hit convert and let it do its thing. Once done, you have a WebM file ready to go to use in OBS Studio as a media source. I recommend doing this for most things you regularly use: green screened overlay clips, alpha channel lower thirds, and other video-based graphics, stinger transitions, and so on. This will make your streams more efficient and keep your resources lightweight. And that's it. WebM is a great format, and I hope to see it get more support as time goes by. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it has, hit the like button, subscribe for more awesome tech videos and OBS courses and things like that. Come follow me on Twitch if you like game streaming and leave me a message in chat. I'm MeeplesVox. I'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.